We're currently working on quantum dots, which are essentially particles that are semiconductors, and we're testing how efficient they are in making solar cell applications. In terms of game changing, is that the most efficient solar cell technology is using silicon, which can only absorb up to 33.3% of the sun's energy. Whereas if we theoretically use quantum dots, we can potentially achieve up to 100% efficiency, because the quantum dots are able to absorb all wavelengths and energy of the sun, whereas silicon is only able to absorb certain wavelengths and not achieve 100% efficiency.
The main impetus for quantum dots is that we can engineer a device to our specifications with a high level of precision. We are not as restricted as we are if we're looking at the bulk materials that are generally available to us. So a chemist can say, I want to combine this certain set of materials, and then we can even link different materials together with certain molecules that have properties of interest. We can design a device that will mimic what nature can do. I really love to tell people that in 1 hour of sunlight, we could power the planet for a whole year. We just can't harness that energy. But if you could have shingles on your house or paint on your house or your driveway out of a solar material, and you didn't have to be hooked up to a grid, you know, that would be ideal. And so that's really the driving force behind this quantum dot technology. Get away from harmful materials, but also the expense.